with regards to the human-to-human transmission question, so right from the start, from the first notification that we received on the 31st of December, given that this was a cluster of pneumonia, I'm a MERS specialist, so my background is in coronaviruses and in influenza, so immediately thought, given that it's a respiratory pathogen, that of course there may be human-to-human transmission.
The deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S. Here's what we know. A Washington state resident fell ill after returning from Wuhan, China, where the outbreak began. Officials now say more than 400 people have been sickened and 9 people have died. The World Health Organization is holding an emergency meeting right now.
On January 14th, I guess it was, that there was no human-to-human transmission. Well, there was. They probably made that statement in the second or third week of December in addition, but they made it very powerfully on January 14th. And they criticized me very strongly when I said that we're going to shut down flights coming in from China.
The focus of all political parties should be to save their people. Please don't politicize this virus. If you want to be exploited, and if you want to have many more body bags, then you do it. If you don't want many more body bags, then you refrain from politicizing it.
And he would have been much better serving the people that he's supposed to serve if they gave a correct analysis. I mean, everything was, I said, China-centric. Everything was going to be fine. No human to human, keep the borders open. He wanted me to keep the borders open. I closed the borders despite him, and that was a hard decision to make at the time. We were all together. We made a decision against the World Health Organization. So when he says politicizing, he's politicizing. That shouldn't be.
We need to make sure it's delivering on those taxpayer dollars. The World Health Organization is no different in that respect. They have to execute on the mission that they are designed to achieve, and we've seen with respect to the World Health Organization. Here we are.
Who was supposed to blow the whistle? The president has asked this question, and I think he's right. The president's answer is the World Health Organization should have been blowing the whistle. Where were the horns that should have been triggered back in December and January?
I think on December 31st in China, and we became aware of this, they said this was just animal to human, period. Now we know retrospectively that there was ongoing transmission from human to human in China, probably at least a few weeks before then. So whose ever fault that was, you know, we're gonna go back and take a look at that when this is all over, but clearly it was not the right information that was given to us.